The title, O Mensch, bewein, dein Sünde groß, means, O man, weep for your great sins. There are 23 verses that tell the story of Easter, mostly focusing on the time from the end of the Last Supper until Jesus' death. This text is supposed to remind us of these things, how serious our sin is, and how wonderful it is that Jesus was willing to die for us. Bach knew this and has put the same meaning into the music. It is a very slow piece indeed, and you can really feel the sorrow and pain throughout, especially in the chromatic bits. You might be pleased to hear that Bach stopped after verse 1, not verse 23, and so that leaves the last line of the piece as for a long time on the cross, the last word being long in the German. The piece is slow, but for that last word, Bach writes adagissimo, which means the tempo halves. You can almost hear Jesus dying there. And yet, it is a fantastically beautiful piece. O dearest Jesus, what law have you broken? The text makes the point that for Jesus to be condemned to such a horrifically painful and humiliating death, he must have done something really terrible to deserve it. Except, of course, Jesus was the only person in history ever to live without sin. In verse 3, it says, "It is for my sins which you, Lord, must languish," which I think really explains the title. It's written by Gabriel Jackson, who is a contemporary English composer. He was born in Bermuda. He started his musical life as a chorister in Canterbury Cathedral before studying composition at the Royal College of Music. His influences are varied and include R&B, so it's a very interesting rhythmical piece.